The witness has testified in his deposition that he doesn't know who the whistleblower is. You have said, even though no one believes you, you have said you don't know who the whistleblower is. So how is this outing the whistleblower to find out who this individual is?
I swear, their playbook never changes. You know how the Democrats and their media are constantly putting forward people who are, in their eyes, above criticism and scrutiny. They do this so when those people inevitably do receive criticism, they can simply deflect it back on the critic instead of addressing the criticism. We see this all the time with the Democrats and their media. When people criticized Obama, they were racist.
What are the Tea Partiers really angry about? Healthcare reform? Or the fact that it was an African-American president and a woman Speaker of the House who pushed through major change.
If you criticize Desmond is amazing or whatever the hell his name is, you're a bigot. If you criticize Hillary Clinton, you're a sexist. Or if you disagree with Greta Thunberg, you're a jerk who picks on kids. It is most definitely part of their strategy of never having to win over people with convincing arguments. That's why they love machine gunning labels at you.
Racist, sexist,
who is a xenophobe,
homophobic,
who is a sexist, who is a religious bigot.
That's why they love mindless chants at their protests, as well as blowing air horns, drumming drums, or basically doing anything other than having an argument to present.
Didn't even let me near the black-only dorm.
And we're seeing this strategy at play once again, and this time in regards to the Democrats' impeachment witness, Lieutenant Colonel Vindman.
In addition to the White House Twitter feed officially attacking one of their own employees, the head of the Ukraine desk on the National Security Council, a decorated war veteran who has shrapnel on his body, as Dana pointed out, Donald Trump Jr. is even the id of the id and just saying whatever he thinks and tweeting whatever he wants, calling the hearings a joke, saying that Lieutenant Colonel Vindman has no credibility and attacking him over and over.
What Republicans did instead is question the credibility of the witness, question the story, repeat conspiracy theories that have been debunked to attack a man in uniform who has shrapnel in his body after getting injured by a roadside bomb while serving this country in a war zone is just mind-blowing.
Okay, here we go with the double standards. Every single one of these people is on Twitter all day long trashing Trump and his supporters. We'll get right back to this media malpractice, but first let me just take a quick moment to thank this video's sponsor, PatrioticLegacy.com. PatrioticLegacy.com was nice enough to send me over one of these units so I could give you an honest review. I love this tactical flashlight. It's got everything you would ever need. 6 overall lighting functions, escape features like the window hammer and the seatbelt cutter, solar charging so you don't need batteries, a power bank for charging your phone and other devices, and a removable compass with access to a personal safety alarm. Patriot Legacy supports veterans and YouTubers like yours truly. So head on over there and make sure to use the promo code DRONE20 to get 20% off your purchase. Thank you. But as usual, they're applying different standards to their political opposition. The Democrat media would have you believe that Colonel Vindman is George Washington, Abraham Lincoln, and Samuel Adams all rolled into one. Let me just say this about Colonel Vindman's service. I have the utmost respect for all veterans and especially Iraq War veterans. My little brother is a U.S. Marine Iraq War veteran who did 3 tours in Iraq. I myself am an Air Force veteran. So I have the utmost respect for his service. That doesn't mean he's above scrutiny. He is a witness in an attempt to impeach the president after all. He exaggerated his resume in his prepared congressional statement, and he overstated his role in the administration. Then there was that time that Jim Jordan exposed both Vindman and Schiff as liars claiming that they didn't know who the whistleblower was. Why did they lie, and why shouldn't they be criticized for it?
You're not willing to tell us who that other individual is.
Mr. Chairman, point of order.
Thank you, counsel. You know, as I indicated before, this committee will not be used to out the whistleblower.
I don't see how this is outing the whistleblower. The witness has testified in his deposition that he doesn't know who the whistleblower is. You have said, even though no one believes you, you have said you don't know who the whistleblower is. So how is this outing the whistleblower to find out who this individual is?
Jordan, this is your time for questioning. You can use it any way you like.
Yeah, Why wouldn't Vindman give the names of the people he communicated with, and why wouldn't Schiff allow him to answer the questions? They would only do that if they knew the name of the whistleblower. Busted.
On your show the day after the election, and I was profoundly alarmed and depressed. These people who are completely suffused with these extremely earnest patriotic values, you know, the sort of values that the Republican Party used to valorize.
When has the left ever been pro-military? Attend any left-wing Democrat rally, and you're gonna find a whole slew of people that hate police and hate the military. During the Bush years, not only did the far-left protesters constantly attack and demonize the military, but so did mainstream Democrats and their media. Berkeley, California, the liberal capital of this country, banned the Marines from recruiting in their city.
The City Council of Berkeley, California has told Marine Corps recruiters that their office, quote, is not welcome in the city, and if recruiters choose to stay, they do so as uninvited and unwelcome intruders.
Oh yeah, so much love from the military on the left. Right now, at the University of North Carolina, Charlotte, they're trying to get the head of campus security fired because he's a veteran that worked at Guantanamo Bay. So much love for the veterans on the left. If this veteran was a witness for the Republicans, do you think they'd be reacting the same way? Obviously not. Just look at how they treated General Petraeus when he took Bush's side in the Iraq offensive of 2007. Or more recently, the highly decorated General Flynn. Just look at how they treated Kyle Kashuv versus how they treated David Hogg. What we're dealing with here is, once again, right out of the DNC playbook. They use human shields that they portray as above scrutiny, then attack the character of anybody who does speak up. The question is, how effective will this tactic be? That's why you should support this channel by subscribing to me on Subscribestar, Patreon, or sending a donation through PayPal. It's imperative that I have the support of you, the viewer, because without it, they'll eventually put all of us under their boot. You can find all the links in the description and the pinned comment. Thank you.